Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, as you can read from the title, I'm going to be starting a project pan plan. A lot of you guys actually have suggested for me to do this, and low-key I sort of subconsciously already do it. It might not seem like it, but I actually don't purchase a lot of makeup, especially when it comes to base products. So I don't really have a lot of primers, foundations, and concealers. I typically have a couple in rotation and I'll try to use those up before I buy anything new. But I thought doing a project pan, I could just be a little bit more conscious and just track everything, because every time I hit pan on something, to me that is just so satisfying, and I'm just getting my money's worth. And I also love filming my empties, so just finishing up products to me is so satisfying. I'm a person that doesn't like wasting anything. If I'm out eating lunch with my friends and they don't finish their food and I finish mine, I'll literally try my best to finish their food, because I just don't like things going to waste. I reuse wrapping paper. When it comes to like my little notebooks, I'll reuse the paper, cut it out into little memo pads to reuse that. I'll just reuse anything that I can just to get my money's worth. So just doing project pan was, I don't know, ideal for me. But before we get started, I want to shout out Kelly Gooch, because she was such a huge help. Watching her videos was just so informative. I'll link her channel down below. She's been project panning for a couple years now and she still is, which is really inspiring. I feel like watching her videos really pushed me to project pan myself. But there was one video of her where she talks about project panning, what it is, why she does it, and how she does it. And that was a really, really helpful video. It was just such a warm, like welcoming sort of video to the project panning community, and it was just really encouraging. It made me feel like, you know, there was no pressure. It was just like, do you sort of thing, you got this sort of vibe, you know. So I'll link it down below, check out her channel, love her content. So yeah, for the first video of my project panning journey, I'm gonna sort of do it like Kelly. She does it like a 1 year sort of plan. So today I'm just gonna share with you the products that are in my plan and sort of where I'm at. We're gonna measure things out and everything like that. If you guys have any recommendations or any tips and tricks to help me out, I would love to hear that, since I am new to this community. Also, let me know how often you guys would like me to update. I was thinking monthly, but maybe that might be too frequent. So let me know your feedback down below. But all right, let's go ahead and jump into the products that are in my plan. I'm gonna go in order in the way that I personally apply my makeup. So the first thing is primer, and the primer that I picked out is the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Hydrating Hyaluronic Acid Primer. As you can see, I'm almost out of this. This is why I wanted to add it into my plan, because I just wanted to finish it up. I have my little Sharpie here, so I'm going to mark a line. I would say it's just right underneath the hyaluronic acid writing. And if you guys would like monthly updates, then we can see our progress next month. But I feel like I definitely could just use this up in the coming month. I feel like that's very doable. And next up, we have the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Foundation. This is a new addition into my collection, but I thought I would add this one because I feel like it's a realistic goal for me. I do like this foundation. It's not like my holy grail favorite, but I do like how it looks on my skin, so I thought I would add it in to my plan. And honestly, I don't know how I'm gonna measure this, because I don't know, when you look at it, I don't know if that's the actual product inside, you know what I mean? Because nothing is moving if you shake it, so it's going to be sort of hard to track. I mean, if I open it up, this is a really new foundation, so I haven't used a lot of it, but if I'm looking inside, I would say maybe I'm up to like where the ColourPop writing is, so maybe I'll mark it there. I know that's not really accurate, but I'm trying. Next up, we have the concealer. This one is from ColourPop. It's their Pretty Fresh concealer. So I pretty much have the Pretty Fresh line in my plan. I've been using this one for a while now. This one's also gonna be hard to measure out as well, but you can sort of see there's like a little white line underneath the Pretty Fresh logo, and I feel like that is sort of where I am up to. This one, maybe I could finish like by the end of the year, perhaps. For my loose powder, I have the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Butter. This one will be a little bit hard to track as well. Everything is a little bit hard to track. If you look through the case, I feel like I got a quarter of the product left. Typically with loose powders, I don't purchase another one until I finish it up. So that's what I mean when I say I sort of already do Project Pan just in my mind. I'm not really keeping track of anything, but this will be really fun to keep track of everything. And for my press powder, I have the AOA Studio Perfect Finishing Press Powder in the shade Sand. As you can see, I've already hit pan on this, which is so satisfying, by the way. But I feel like this one, maybe by the end of the year, I possibly could finish. I feel like there wasn't a lot of product in here to begin with. I mean, this product is only $1, but that is the little pan we have right now. For setting spray, I have the 3CE Makeup Fixer Mist. I've had this for so long. I love the mist, but I hate the nozzle, so I sort of stopped using it for a bit, and I just kind of use it to spray my brushes, but I have just like a teeny tiny bit left. Definitely this coming month, I could finish this for sure. Like, wet my brushes, set my face down, I could finish that. So I'm gonna leave a little mark here. Okay, next I have some brow products. First one is the Winky Luxe Uni Brow, and this is one of those like triangle brow pencils, but this is the brow pencil that I use to sort of get my shape going and just to get some color because my eyebrows are really, really sparse. I also have the ColourPop Brow Boss pencil in the shade Soft Black. So I actually just finished my NYX brow pencil, and this is the one that I had backup of, so I am just going to finish this one up. I did purchase another NYX brow pencil because that's like my holy grail brow pencil, but I won't use that NYX brow pencil until I finish up this one. I'm so scared to roll this up and then it's just going to snap on me. And the last brow product is the Anastasia Brow Powder Duo in the shade Dark Brown, and I sort of have no hope for this product because I've been trying to finish this product for years. I've had this since I was in high school, and it's been like 5 or 6 years since I finished high school, and it still looks like this. I mean, I've created such a huge dent in it. I really don't know when am I going to finish this product because I've been using it for years and years, so I would just add it in. It would be nice to see my progress month by month. I have no other brow powder other than this one for the past 6 years, so 6-7 years. Then for eye primer, I have the Kaleidos Tone Activator Eye Primer. I've been using this one for the past 2 months, and I feel like this might take me a while to finish up because you only need a little bit of this product, but this is the only eye primer that I have. Before, I would use my concealer, but I wanna use this one up. And for my eyeshadow palette, I decided to go with the 3CE Multi Eye Color Palette in Overtake. I know I literally just uploaded my review on this, but I feel like this palette would be ideal for this plan because it's a palette that I see myself using every single day, and I feel like for this plan, like, I don't want to use products that I'm not really vibing with, you know? I want to use products that I like and I enjoy. It is really new. I've only used it like a handful of times, so it'll be nice to see how often I can use it and also the little dents I can make in it. So yeah, this is going to be the eyeshadow of choice. For my mascara, I have the Fenty Beauty Full Frontal Mascara. This one is probably almost on its way out. It is drying up a lot. Next up is my bronzer. I don't really know how to go about this palette because I mainly only use the two bronzers, but these two are the only bronzers that I use because the only bronzers in my collection that I actually really, really like right now. So you can see on the two bronzers, I've made a pretty good dent. Like, the print of it is sort of gone, so I want to hit pan on the bronzers. Maybe I'll dabble into the blushes and highlighters, but I'm mainly just going to focus on the two bronzers. I always mix the two. For my blush, I got the ColourPop Super Shock Cheek in the shade Between the Sheets. This is another product that I feel like is almost impossible to pan because I've been trying to pan this up for a really long time. I've made such a huge dent in it, and I feel like I can almost see the pan, but because it's like that, you know, what is it, creamy sort of texture, like, it's almost hard to get to the pan. I feel like if this was a powder, definitely. And this is like a really good daily blush, so that's in my plan. For my highlighter, I decided to go with the Dose of Colors Fuego highlighter. This one is in collaboration with Desi and Katie. This is one of my holy grail highlighters. You can see I have made a dent into it. I haven't hit pan. I personally stopped using powder highlighters. I've been sticking to more cream highlighters, but I really like this highlighter and I want to hit pan on it, so I'm going to try and use this guy up. This is like a very limited edition product. I don't think it's going to be around forever since it is a collaboration. And for the last product in my plan. This is the Dear Dahlia Paradise Blooming Balm in the shade Fantasy. I picked this one out because again, it's a great daily lip color because it is a tinted lip balm, and it's also because I only have a teeny tiny bit left. I've been trying to like save this guy up because it is a pretty pricey product and I didn't want to like repurchase another one, but I have found other products that sort of give me a similar effect, so I feel like I'm happy to like finish this up. And for this product, I'm pretty hopeful that I could finish it up in the coming month, and that you guys were all of the products in my Project Pan plan. There are no eyeliners because for me, my eyeliners, I don't want to sort of use up because I go through them so quickly, so I didn't add them in my plan. But who knows, next month I might have like new additions. I might take out some things, add different things in. Who knows? But that is the plan right now. If you guys are project panning as well, I would love to hear about your experience or your progress. If you could send me some photos or anything like that, I feel like it would be super encouraging and just give me a little bit of like a push to really start panning on some of these products. But if you guys are not, after watching this video, after watching Kelly's video, are you more intrigued? Is it something that you guys would like to try out for yourself and just challenge? And like she said in her video, it doesn't have to be a year long. You could just do it for a month. You could just see like how much product can I use up in a month. But if you guys did enjoy this video and you are excited for my project panning journey, be sure to give this video a thumbs up so I know you're here with me and you guys want to see more project panning videos. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe. I love you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.